Hello everyone and welcome back to Assassin's Creed Revelations, where we left off, we just got the 4th Masyaf key, and I thought I'd leave it until this episode to go ahead and do the Altair memory, because quite frankly, I thought, I'd rather do the Altair memory separately, you know, I'd just rather do that, it's a better idea, you know. The Altair missions are very important, and I'd like them to be kind of like the main part of a video, or like an episode and stuff, so I would very much like to do the Altair section separately and in a new episode instead of having to have just a really long one episode. So we're just gonna go ahead and go back to the Galata den. There's the Galata tower right there, looking beautiful. And we're gonna go back there and we're just gonna go ahead and do this memory, and everything's gonna be great. Everything will be fucking great. Let's go. I love the Altair memories. I'm pretty sure we'll be playing as old Altair though. Pretty sure. Actually, I'm positive that we will be. It's gonna be when he comes back to Masyaf after all those years. That's what it's going to be. Just you wait. It's going to be a very old Altair. It's going to be about 82. I feel like when he's 82, it'll be 10 years before he dies, and then he'll die in like the next one. Spoiler alert, Altair actually dies. He's not like 300 years old at this point, where Ezio's living, you know. Spoiler fucking alert. Let's go and let's relive the next memory, guys. Let's do it. Look at the shiny disc, man. It's a very shiny, boy. There you go. Time for some Altair action. We're just slamming around in here with all the weird furtive structures going on about the place. I don't want that bit. It's weird. Whenever you load up an Altair memory, there's weird, like, furtive shit all over the place.
They say he screams in his sleep, calling out for his father.
Abbas, what a miserable man.
It is not our place to judge.
It certainly is. If our master has gone mad, I would like to know.
Shh. Good evening.
Water.
Of course. Sit.
Many thanks. What brings you here, old man?
Pity Abbas. Do not mock him. He has lived as an orphan for most of his life, shaped by his family's legacy. He is desperate for power, because he is powerless.
He is our mentor, and unlike Al-Mu'alim or Altair, he never betrayed us.
Nonsense. Altair was no traitor. He was driven out. Unjustly. Ugh. Is it you? I heard rumors, but I did not believe them.
I wonder if I might speak to Abbas myself. It's been a long time.
Impossible. Abbas uses rogue Fedayeen to keep us from the castle.
Fewer than half the fighters here are true assassins.
So, where do I begin?
With us.
I love this bit, man. It's so fucking awesome. Oh, it's so good, man. This is literally... Oh, it's one of the best parts in Revelations, this memory. It's so
you
fucking good.
These men are cruel. Has anyone raised his blade against an innocent?
Alas, yes. Brutality seems to be their sole joy.
Then they will die, for they have compromised the Order. But those who still live by the Creed must be spared.
You can trust in us.
There you go. The ones that still live by the Creed must be spared.
Altair.
We need to kill these faggots.
People say an old assassin saved the life of a merchant down in the valley.
Oh, that bit's so cool.
They say he fought with a hidden blade.
If you guys have read the book, that bit's actually in it. Wait, what's that? Do not kill anyone but Abbas and his captains. Is that it? These are his captains. But yeah, it's so awesome in the book where Altair, he's like old, he's on the road back to Masyaf to this bit here. And he, there's this merchant that's getting harassed by two people, and he like fucks him up. Like he has a huge battle with them because he's so old, it takes him a long while to dispatch both of them. But it is an awesome fight because he's so old and he just fucking is wrecking both of them. Although they do overpower him in a way, but he still manages to kill them. There's Maria, there she is. Altair has overcome his depression, you know, after Maria died and he's obsessing over the apple. And now he's come through and he is a powerful power. Altair is so fucking awesome, I love him. I love Altair.
I do not want to get him killed.
That'd be bad. But everyone's still calls him Mentor, because the assassins have become this just fucking shit. Oh god, damn, they're fucking dead. Let's go kill his captain here.
Stand down on that.
Fucking hell, we just fucked him up.
Spill no blood if you can help it.
We're gonna mess him up. Spill no blood if you can help it. See, Altair, he does it through an honorable cause. Oh, Masyaf Castle looks so fucking good. It's so cool, look at it. It's badass. It's awesome. I do love it's a really interesting thing. It's like, because it's a real place. Obviously, it doesn't look as grand as this. But it was where the assassins were until they were abolished. Because in real life, obviously, they were abolished. But, but yeah, it's great. Masyaf Castle just looks so cool. I love it. There's an assassin climbing up there. You can see him. Oh, God. He just died. Don't look at that. Don't look at that guy. Just fucking died. How did that happen?
Two decades have passed since we last saw you within these walls.
He's gonna try and fight me.
We could
Gamir.
Now more than ever.
Oh. Yeah, boy. That guy's cool. Oh, this bit is so good. Altair just has to walk through. He just has to walk.
Kill him! Kill him now! What are you waiting for? You fools! He has bewitched you!
Our mentor has returned!
Oh yeah, boy. Altair is gonna fuck you up, Abbas. I'm just walking through. Oh shit.
For the order.
Damn it.
Welcome home. My blade.
You have to use your fists at this bit, don't you? Oh, it doesn't matter anymore anyway.
Altair.
What the fuck? Yeah, you guys can just die. There you go. He died, fucking hell. Let's select our hidden blades again. Here we go, lads. Here we go. Abbas is right there.
Tell your men to stand down.
No! I am defending Masyaf. Would you not do the same?
You corrupted everything we stand for and lost everything we gained. All of it sacrificed on the altar of your own spite.
And you! You have wasted your life, staring into that apple, dreaming of your own glory.
That is true, Abbas. I learned many things from the apple, of life and death, of the past and the future. Let me show you.
Oh yeah. Shows Maria dying, fucking hell. Come here, Abbas. Oh, it's so fucking good. It's such an awesome bit, man. I love it.
I can never forgive you, Altair. The lies you told about my family, my father,
the humiliation I suffered.
They were not lies, Abbas. I was 10 years old when your father came to see me. He was in tears, begging to be forgiven for betraying my family. Then he cut his own throat. I watched his life ebb away at my feet. I will never forget that image.
No!
But he was not a coward, Abbas. He reclaimed his honor.
I hope there is another life after this one. Then I will see him and know the truth of his final days. And when it is your time, we will find you. And then there will be no doubts.
That bit is so great. It's amazing. Let's run quickly as old Altair now. Let's sprint about. Whee! But yeah, that bit is, it's so good. It's so good. Who would have thought that Abbas from Assassin's Creed 1 would have become a huge problem? Like, it's odd. Because he's like such a kind of like, he's not an awfully big character in the original Assassin's Creed 1. But man, I love that. Altair is fucking great. I love him. And one of the best characters ever.
Still, he fought to hold our brotherhood together. I would have called him stubborn in my youth, but now I can only admire his courage. The assassins were his life, from beginning to end. He had no other.
There you go. Ezio admires Altair. Ezio's a little Altair fanboy, you know? He's a little Altair fanboy, man. Let's check if I've actually got any weapons. Where's the... Oh! Captain Sword. Shivona. Damn, all these swords are here. Wasn't this the... I swear the Shivona was like the best sword in Assassin's Creed, in the other Assassin's Creed games, like that you could buy. Is the Sicilian Rapier better? Seems like it is. It is better. Well, I'll use that instead. I guess it's because it's a sword that the Shivona is a sword that you can just like buy, I guess. That's not the Master Assassin. I thought it was Master Assassin then. Yeah, the Shivona is a sword that you get for free. So I guess that's why it's not considered as powerful, because that'd be a bit overpowered. All right, let's go to Cappadocia then. That's, I guess, where we're going now. We're going to Cappadocia. I don't know what we're going to do, actually. Also, I thought it would be the end of the sequence now, to be quite fair, but I guess it isn't. Yep, but who cares? Let's just fast travel. Where's the fast travel station? Let me have a little look. There's one over there. Let's go there, to the tunnel entrance. Have a little sprint. Oh, actually, we can buy the Bayezid's knife. Let's go buy that. The Bayezid's knife. Oh. Bayezid's knife. Oh no, that's not. Standard stiletto, Arabian dagger, butcher's knife, Macedonian dagger. Oh, that's the one I want. The Bayezid's knife's the one I want. I saw Janissary's Kijil. You can get that if you want. It's quite cool. Yeah, it's quite cool. It's got better damage. Or we could buy the heavy weapon. You know, we could buy the French bastard sword. Oh, that's got worse everything than my current sword. Bearded axe. This axe. It's got a great deflect. Let's just get the Janissary's Kijil. Seems pretty good. Yeah, there's the Sipahi riding stuff. Weird. It looks like fucking Minecraft diamond armor or some shit. Some weird fucking... I fucking hate Minecraft. I used to do that on this channel. Jesus Christ. I actually private all the videos because I just didn't want them on my channel anymore. It's awful. Shitty fucking shit fuck Minecraft. I hate it. But yeah, that's all of our money gone there. But it was worth it, I guess. It was worth it. No, more notifications. It's all good. It's all fine. Let's just get to this, get to this tunnel entrance. Because we can. Then we'll just go ahead and fast travel. Everything will be great. There you go, look at that. Look at that. Let us fast travel to the mission. Okay. It is that one. The Grand Bazaar. It is the Grand Bazaar. I like the Grand Bazaar, it's great. It's a fun time. This sword literally looks almost identical to Yusuf's Turkish Kilij. They spelt Kilij wrong. They put Kijil. How the fuck do they manage to... How the fuck do they manage that? I cannot believe it. Now we can just take the waypoint off the map. There you go. And then we can get going to the mission. It's only a few hundred meters away. That's fine. That is fine. Yeah, boy. Use that fucking hook blade. Oh, shit. See you later, lads. I apologize. Oh, there's a little tailors there, boy. I don't even know why I sounded interested in that. I don't fucking care about the tailors. Please accept my apologies, Effendi. Oh, God. There you go. There you go.
Sayun Auditore. Word around the city is you're leaving us.
Is nothing I do a secret.
Not to worry, brother. The captain of your ship is a friend. But neither of you are going anywhere just yet. The Janissaries have raised the chain across the mouth of the Halic and ordered a full blockade until you are caught.
They raised the chain for me.
We will celebrate later. Here, I have something for you. Careful. This has 50 times the kick of our usual bombs.
I love this mission, man. It's the E3 demo.
The suspense is palpable.
Yusuf, wait. Un favore.
Yes?
There is a woman running a bookshop at the old Polo trading post. Sophia. Look out for her. She is a remarkable lady.
You have my word.
Gather your men. This will attract some attention.
I love this mission. It's great. It's the E3 demo. It's you can always tell when you do when you're gonna do like an E3 demo sort of thing. You always know. Let's distract these guys. But yeah, it's great. There you go. And let's go over here. Yeah, but they're always such well-structured missions. Okay, that Janissary, I'm going to call my assassins on him. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to take him out myself. Oh, fuck. Do not kill anyone with blades? Oh, that's fucking annoying. Who cares? Interact. Here we go then. Use an arrow storm. Oh, that was awesome. Fucking love the arrow storm, it's great. There's our assassins, there's Yusuf. Okay, time to use the fucking Greek fire. This bit is such a good fucking mission. I love it. Look at that, man. Oh, damn, there's a fucking classic lad there. Let's just destroy the whole boat. Whole ship, I mean, not the boat. There you go, look at that. It reaches pretty damn far, doesn't it? There you go, that's dead. Oh god, what's happening? These are all the fire starts going everywhere. Let's destroy that ship. There you go, that ship is up in flames. And then we can just get this one. All those people are just casually dying. There you go, let's fuck those cannons up. Let's just fuck you and your cannons. This Greek fire goes a long way. There you go. It's so cool. It like this whole bit changes. There you go. That cannonball has fucked us up there. Time to have a nice little run along. Board your ship before it leaves. Let's go, boy. Oh, this bit's so cool. It's one of those awesome set pieces in Revelations. They're just fucking awesome. Let's go. Ezio, be careful, man. Ezio, be very, very careful. Oh shit. There you go. There you go.
Don't let him reach the ship.
Let's just run. Let's just run for it. There you go. Fuck you guys. See you later.
Yours is not a subtle approach.
See. Sorry for the delay.
It's so fucking good. That music, man. It's so good. Oh my god, it's fucking beautiful. It is beautiful music. Like, I just can't fucking deal with that. It's such a beautiful piece of music, man.
I have a hunch.
Yes.
Come on, Bill. You never do anything halfway. What do you think we'll find?
If we're lucky, another prize. If we're very lucky, something that will end this miserable war.
You're talking over my head, mate.
Listen, Sean, I have no idea what we're going to find. But I do know that whatever it is, the Templars can't have it.
The Templars can't have it. No, that's probably great, because it's not meant for the Templars. It's meant for Desmond.
Do you regret anything, Desmond?
Like what?
Running away, leaving your parents behind, finding a shit job and pretending to be productive. What's it like spending your whole life avoiding hard decisions?
Come on.
Sure, you're an assassin, but it wasn't your choice.
Do you have a point?
I want to know if you regret anything.
Sure. I wish I'd been more patient with my parents. I wish I'd listened. And Lucy. Maybe things could have been different if I'd... I'm not sure.
Thank you.
For what?
For making sense.
Once we get to Cappadocia, I think we're gonna end the episode. Because it'll probably be like quite a... You know, okay. Oh.
Sure, yeah, God, no, I'm fine, yeah.
Let's listen to this first.
After all, aren't we, eh? Why should we be surprised if one of us dies every now and again?
Every death is a tragedy to somebody somewhere.
What I want to know is, Is Desmond worth all this trouble? You know, what is he? Is he the chosen one? Is that it? Little Jimmy special? Some bollocks like that?
I'm afraid not. But what he has is rare. His genes contain high concentrations of First Civilization DNA. Only about 1 in 10 million are so lucky.
Oh, the bleeding effect. Is that part of it?
I believe so. I wish I could say we knew about his gift earlier. But it was the Templars who realized this. And they found him first.
There you go, a bit of background information there. Sort of let you guys listen to that, because it is important. But yeah, I'm not going to do the shitty Desmond story stuff in the background on Animus Island, because it's a bit shit.
To a region called Cappadocia, where Manuel is training his soldiers. If I am lucky, I will not be alone, for there may be Ottoman spies in the area waiting to strike. But, as ever, I put stock only in myself and hold the memory of dear Sophia close to my heart. Claudia, you would laugh to hear the racing thoughts of your brother now. I have come to admire Sophia with more affection than I thought possible. After the death of Christina, something withered in me. But that feeling, that capacity for love, has returned. I adore Sophia, but dare not drag her into this life of mine. Not without fear of hurting her, or driving her away.
Bless Ezio, man. Bless him. But yeah, here we are, arriving in Cappadocia. Sequence 7, Underworld. This bit is... it's kind of cool. You know, Cappadocia's not the best place, but it's a kind of cool bit in the game.
No evidence of an army here. And no signs of Tariq's men.
Right, okay. We are now in Cappadocia. I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. I hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to go ahead and like and subscribe for more Assassin's Creed content in the future. And also remember to comment down in the comment section below what you thought of this video. And I'll see you guys in the next one with some more Cappadocia. Bye!